In this release, we are launching a new capability of Power Apps called Power Apps Portals, which allows you to engage with your customers by building low-code, no-code, high-fidelity, responsive websites for users external to your organizations as well as your employees. With Power Apps Portals, you can use any of the commercial or enterprise login providers like Microsoft Account, LinkedIn, Azure AD B2C, or even allow anonymous access. It comes with the WYSIWYG designer to create all your website content, which is stored in Common Data Service, as well as enrich your website with Common Data Service data using familiar constructs like forms, views, charts, and dashboards. Let's see how it works in action. So with this release, if you go to make.powerapps.com, you will see a new option to create a portal. You can create a portal simply by clicking on portal from blank tile. And fill in few, like once the pop-up opens up, you can provide a name to your portal. So let me call it portal demo. And then I can choose a domain name for my portal. Every portal by default will be created with poweressportals.com domain name. And then you can change it later to your custom domain names as well. So I'm gonna just say portals demo. And once done, I can also decide which language I want to create my portal in. We support 43 base CDS languages, so you can use any one of them except right-to-left languages. So once I've done, given a domain name, so this is already in use, so I'm just gonna add another syllable to it just to see it is available. So once I've given a proper domain name, I can go ahead and create my portal. Now, at this point of time, this will create a website for me, which my end consumers can access and put me in the designer experience where I can go and modify this website. So once you have done all of this, the designer experience will load up, which will allow you to customize the website any way you want it to look like. And once the designer experience load up, you will see a bunch of options which are available to customize various portions of this website. So I can go create web pages, I can go add components to my web pages, as well as I can go customize my web templates, which is the developer experience which we provide within the designer experience. So for this demo, what we'll be doing is creating a website where I have a nice homepage, where I can go and create bookings, as well as see my past booking as a consumer. And this is the homepage which I want to create here. So I go into Portal Designer Experience. The top first thing I can do is go change my logo. So I can actually go select the image present in my logo section. Can either upload a new image to change it. I can use one of the existing images I have already uploaded, or I can give it an external URL where images can be hosted in a CDN or a blob storage, and those can be rendered inline as well. For now, I will leave it as it is because Contoso Limited is the company I'm creating a portal for. Now, let's go ahead and try to mimic this homepage experience. So to do that, I need a section at the top where I can have a nice background as well as an image in it. So I'll go select from one of the components, and one of the components which we ship is a one column section. So let me select that. Once I've selected a one column section, I want to give it a background, so that it actually appears nice, and then I can add an image on top of it. So for background, I have two options. I can actually fill it with a color. So I can use my color picker to give it a nice color, or I can actually use an image. So I'm gonna choose an existing image from here, which I've already uploaded. And once that image is present, if you'll see the screen, so this is the kind of image we had, but then there's another one on top of it. So let me go ahead and add another image on top of this experience. So to do that, I'll go to my component section again, choose an image, and once I've selected an image, I can upload a new one. But again, I have already pre-uploaded all the images, so I'm gonna use an existing one. And once this is uploaded, I'll resize it a bit so that it appears similar to what we want to create in our experience. Now, once done, I am done with my top section. Now let me focus on the bottom one. So to do that, I'll go add another section from my components layout. So I'm gonna add a three column section. And then each of these three columns, I want to go add an image. So I'll go select an image for each of these three and then use the images which I've already uploaded. So that's two. And then let's add another image component. And then go select the images which we have present here. So I'm going to add a foot massage image. I'm going to add unwind image. And then I'm going to add another one for facial. So with that, it's kind of looking like how I want this thing to look like. Oops, there's a mistake. I actually don't want these images here. So I'm going to go delete this section and then add it outside this whole thing. So let me go add a three column section here and then select images like we did last time. So I'm just making sure you guys absolutely learn how to add sections and images by after looking at this video. That's why we are doing it again and again. So, okay, let's select a foot massage image. Then let's select unwind image and then let's select a facial image. So once done, it kind of looks like how I want it to look like. But next step here is adding some text at the bottom. So to do that, I'll select my sections again and add another section at the bottom of the page. This one will again be a three column section, but this one I want to add text because I want to show some headings on these images. So I'm going to go add text to each of the columns of this section. All right, and then I'll go write down the text which I want to write down. So this is foot massage. And then I want it to be slightly bigger. Okay, and bold. So let me just make it bold. And this is unwind. And same thing, we are going to select the same font size and we are going to make it bold. And then I'm going to say facial here. So I'm going to make it same size and make it bold. But again, these don't look like arranged neatly. So let me go and kind of like fix the whole section. So I can select the section and do all central line. So everything becomes central line. Let me try to do that same thing with images because they look a bit off as well. And then let me center line even my top section. Oh, no, that doesn't look good. So let me just put it back. Cool. So once done, we are actually created a portal. We have created the whole page, how we want it to look like. So let's see how it actually appears. So the browse website action present in the designer allows you to directly see what you have been working on. And the moment you do browse website, it also publishes changes on your portal. So once I've done that, I have a portal already created, which shows the same thing which we were just trying to build. So this is where it brings in the power of the portal designer experience. And all of this content is coming from CDS. So it brings in the power of CDS and the familiar low-code experience of Power Apps in order to simplify your website creation tremendously. So with that, so this was the first thing and this was simple. It's not that hard to do. But now let's try to create the experience where we can let people interact with common data service data. So what I want to do is I want to create a page which allows me to show a grid of like all the previous bookings my customer had, as well as allow them to create new bookings. So to do that, I'll go ahead and create a new page. So I'll just choose a blank page because I want to figure out what content I want to put in there. And so I can just go here and go click on a blank page. Blank page is one of the templates we ship. And then I can go ahead and start adding like information to this page. So this comes in. I don't really want this text. I'm going to say, hey, see my bookings. And again, do the same thing. Change the font sizes. Make it a bit bold so that it looks good. Then I want to add a list on it, like a list of my bookings. Now, it is very, like, if you have already played around with portals before, you know that it can take a lot of time to add a list onto this page. But with the new portal designer experience, we have made it super simple to do. So I can just go to my component section and choose a list component. Once I do that, it's going to add me a placeholder and I can actually go ahead and start filling out its properties. So I can give it a name. So I'll give it a name called My Booking. And then I can select the CDS entity I want to display here. So this is showing a list of all the entities present in my CDS instance. So I have already created an entity called Spa Booking. So I'm going to select that. And then once I've selected that, it shows me all the views I have created. So now this is familiar. If you have played around with common data service, you know how views are created. You know how you can create different filters in the views. You can directly use that on your portal. So I'm going to go and select active spa booking page because I only want to show active spa bookings. And then what I want to also do in this list is give people an option to create a new record. So I'm going to go and enable create new record. So when I do that, it's the next thing is going to ask me, hey, how you are going to actually create a new record? Are you actually going to, you have to open a form. So I can open a form directly, which is a model-driven form, or I can open a new web page. That web page can have a form in it and like everything will be linked together. So I'm going to select a web page here and I have already created a form which has a, like already created a page which has a form which you can use to create records. So I'm going to go select that new booking form here. Once done, there's some advanced setting I can do, like show a message when there's no records in the list, define how many records show up, enable search, enable permissions, like bunch of those actions. I'm going to skip those, but I'm going to also enable a view detail action. View detail action will allow my users to see all the records as well as go and see more details of that record. So open up a form whenever they click on it. So I'm for that experience, I'm going to show up a form in like a modal window. And I'm going to use an existing model-driven form which I had created for this entity. So I'm going to use that. Now, once done, like my page is created, everything is set up. So this all looks good. But look at this at the top. Like my page name is new page 12. Like I don't want that. I have to change it. So I'll go ahead and edit my page property. So I'm going to call it my booking. And then I'll leave my URL as my booking as well. So this defines the URL of my page so people can go directly on it. So once I change that, you see all my navigation is adjusting automatically to whatever changes I'm making. And now I talked about that I already created a form or a page which had a form in it. So let me go quickly to that to show you what I had done there. So on this page, I wanted an experience where people can come in, fill up a form, and it creates a booking record in my common data service. So I have created this page and I've added a form component on it. And form is like another one of the component which you can add. So once you add a form component similar to grid, you actually fill up a bunch of details for it. And the most important component is actually using a model-driven form which you have created in common data service. So this is a form which I already created. So it is all using familiar components. You don't have to learn anything new. It's just going to render differently in your portal. So with that, I am pretty much done with what all I wanted to do in this portal. So I'm going to go ahead and do browse website and publish all the changes we have made and land us on the portal. So if you see here that these are all the changes which we did to homepage, they appear exactly like the image we talked about in the beginning. And then I have this My Bookings page. I'm already logged in. So I should be able to go here and see all the bookings which I've made. So which appears here. So all of this data is coming from your common data service. I added a view details page. So I should be able to go click on it and see the details of my bookings as well. So once I do that, if you'll see, it's going to load up a form which shows all the details of this record which I just created. So all these details appear there for all the bookings I have present in the system. And then I can also go and create a new booking. So I can just go click there. It shows up a form which we selected while creating it. I can say that, hey, create a booking for 20th. I can choose an offer which already exists. So I want to do a head massage. I can choose a date and time. So I was talking about 20th. Leave comments, I don't really care. I'm gonna do it on London Heathrow and do a submit. Once I've done that, all my records are created in CDS and I can actually go to my bookings and see that. Like this is the booking I just created. So with this, like you have seen how easy it is to get your common data service data and expose it to your customers outside of your organization. With all like a simple WYSIWYG no code experience and create a completely branded experience for your company.